Welcome to the fifth and last round of the Legacy Challenge, not daily event. We are on the play again, which makes us on the play 3 out of 5 games, so slightly above average. Unfortunately, we have to make up for this by mulliganing this otherwise amazing hand. Like, if this was land, woo. But let's see. Oh, this is good. This is turn 3 Nissa once again. See, this deck is crazy. Like, the I'm pointing at Gaia's Cradle and Nissa, by the way, on my screen. These two cards together, they completely annihilate Legacy. And I'm totally not overestimating the impact of these cards. I think I'm gonna do it like this. Because I know I'm about to draw a land, so next turn I can go Heritage Druid into Cradle and get... What's the card I wanted to get? Visionary, right. Volcanic Island again, not a fan. Not a fan. Maybe she's just gonna play Delver or something, or Ponder. Oh, Dismember? Okay. So it looks like some kind of Delver, where I drew like the 1 off or 2 of Dismember. No, I'm not a big fan of drawing a land here, but okay. What can you do? So if I do it like this, and I fetch Dryad Arbor end of turn, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I need to draw Quarian Ranger? No, it doesn't do it. There's no really good way for me. I think I'm just gonna get another Deathrite, since he's shown to be really scared of the card. We're not getting full maximum value out of our cards right now, because this card always wants to be a Visionary, because Visionary is Demonic Tutor of a random card in your deck. And also getting a fetch land, but a fetch land to Dryad was always the highest value when you have Gaia's Cradle, but it's okay. Still have a super high impact card, and he didn't have Delver before, so I think he also doesn't have Delver here. Wonder which kind of decision he has to make. Swift Spear? Oh, and he drew Delver. Okay. Or maybe he already had Delver and he really, really wanted to kill Deathrite. That could be another thing. Yeah. Okay. Heritage Druid first, because if I draw this, if I play this first and he dazes it, then I don't have Heritage Druid on the board. Whereas by doing it this way, at least I will have Heritage Druid on the board, even if he dazes this. Double Nissa, okay. No Caber Therapy one time. In before he flips off Caber Therapy. Or probe into Caber Therapy, that would be crazy. Out or doesn't flip at all. I wonder whether he's gonna attack here. Because I'm certainly not gonna block. But he doesn't know that. Oh fuck, Wasteland. Now I would block, I think. But he could top deck Cradle. Huh. Brainstorm, now he's not gonna attack. It's... Oh, this is a really bad brainstorm. This is a horrible brainstorm. I mean, yes, maybe you were gonna play it anyway, because you really want to flip that Delver and be more mana efficient. But having already played a land, playing a main deck brainstorm here, the only value you get from that is the F6 value. And... but okay. Let's see. If we draw Cradle... By the way, Cradle doesn't... what was I thinking? Cradle doesn't even cast Nissa. Attacking. Interesting. Oh, this is... So basically we could draw Visionary next turn into Cradle and then have enough mana to cast Nissa. The thing is, which card do I want to draw? Like, this has more top decks. This gives us Senate and Biowood Symbiotes as top decks, whereas this eventually gets us to Nissa, but I think we have to do it like this. Because if we are gonna lose a creature here, we are still pretty far from turning on Heritage to it. We actually drew the card I wanted to draw, but it wouldn't have worked anyway. Now we're just gonna get him for 2, put some pressure on, maybe he's gonna play Pyromancer, then we're gonna attack for another 2. Sure, I'm not gonna have 6, I'm gonna pretend I have Abrupt Decay. What's it gonna be? Another brainstorm. That brainstorm was so... Like, the entire turn was really like... Land drop first into brainstorm into throw away your Delver. I wonder if he's gonna. He actually takes out the cradle. But now he needs to play something. He must have Forcefull plus pitch in hand. Just because, like, he's not doing anything. Oh, what's this? Is it Bolt? No, Bolt and Visionary would be so random. Okay. I mean, yeah, Fog Bolt makes sense because we have Pendlehaven, I guess. And now we're getting to the point where it's awkward. Oh, this is actually Canadian Threshold. I should have thought about it when I saw the dismember, I guess. Okay, this is a great card to draw. Wonder if, whether he lets this reserve. Okay, he does. And now if you draw one mana elf, preferably Birchall Ranger. Ah, this is good enough. This actually does cast Nissa next turn. And this time it really does. Four cards in hand. Three cards in hand. He could block Bounce to buy some time. Or just really just go for Nissa. But then we're guaranteed to take 8 damage if he has Spell Pierce or Daze. Game 1 against Canadian Threshold is one of those really must-win games because the difference between Game 1 and 2 is quite significant. Because after boarding they get like 2 Rough Tumble and sometimes, like in the, back in the day, definitely they also submerge, but these days not necessarily submerge anymore. I think I'm really just gonna gain life here. It's a bit too scary. Also, I'd rather untap and maybe draw something and then eventually go for a safer Nissa. Or maybe even make him make a first move or something. Diver? Oh, another dismember. Okay, so we would have been punished had we tried to go for Nissa, because then he would have killed a Dryad Arbor in response to us trying to untap it. But he also could have done this pre-Mongoose. Okay, now he's down to a single card. Maybe if you draw another Quirion Ranger, we can surprise kill him at some point. And not surprise kill him, because 8 is still greater than 5. And we are taking 7 damage next turn, so we go down to 11, then we surprise hit him for 6 actually. But he's got 2 cards. And like, I've played enough games against this kind of deck to know that the last 2 cards are Force plus either Daze or Spell Pierce. And keeping Spell Pierce would also make perfect sense, because he thinks he's up against Natural Order and wants to Spell Pierce that. Okay, now it's just Spell Pierce and Daze. Cradle would be nice. Oh, and he's... Ooh. No, they keep coming. 1, 2, 3. What's a bit annoying is if he actually takes this one out, then this one grows bigger. Oh, wow. Oh, what am I gonna do now? I'm a bit lost now. Do it like this. Oh, Stifle. Okay, okay. Oh, interesting. So it was Stifle. Or, like some people would say in German, Stifle. Stifler. Isn't a guy like in American Pie, isn't he called Stifler in English as well? It would be so weird if you... No, he's pretty sure he's called Stifler in English as well. Not Stifler. That would be a really weird name. Hey, this is my friend Stifler. Wanna meet him? Okay, so... What's it gonna be? Throw everything at Nissa or at me? If he throws everything at me, I'm not dead. and I crack back for lethal, but if he has like a bolt or a creature, then I lose. Oh, this is annoying. Oh, no, it's not. Okay. So trusted me. I can actually make 2 5/5s next turn. And then he blocks one of them, and... I think I can just take 7 here. Does he have another stifle? Glimpse. Drawing a forest is actually not the worst. Oh, is there anything in the graveyard I want to get back, by the way? I actually didn't think about that. Is there something in the graveyard? Something in the water, something in the graveyard? How much mana do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. I've got 11 mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, yeah. So I could minus for Visionary and minus for Deathrite Chair and try to glimpse him. It's a bit of a weird line, actually. Maybe I should just make 5/5s and keep doing my thing. It's just getting the second Nissa is so tempting. Okay, this is the first time in quite a long while that I really feel lost about the situation. Not lost, but not sure about how I want to approach it. I think I'm gonna try this. He doesn't have a sniper, okay. Then I'm gonna make the second Nissa. I would like to keep this one. And then I should make this a 5/5. Actually, I might need... No, I... Yeah, the Pendlehaven. Oh, this is awkward. I can't play a land anymore. So if I make this a 5/5, then these two deal 3. And then I need, but if I want to untap this, then I need to bounce this, so this doesn't work. So this will definitely be in my hand. And if this is a 5/5, then it's 7 damage no matter which way. Okay. What if I use the Pendlehaven first? I'm so stupid. I should just use it first. And then I'm gonna make it a 5/5. And then I'm gonna untap this. And then there's probably something that I completely forgot about. But if not, then I get a pretty cool win. I mean, there's not a lot of cards that he can have. Like, Bolt could do it. Bolt would actually win the game, yeah. But I think I wasn't beating Bolt anyway. Chaka!
Perfect!
Ha! Okay, that was pretty sweet. This Nissa, huh? Good card. Oh, this... I can't be too loud because in my new apartment I still haven't figured out how loud I can be in at night for my... I was about to say my opponents. No, my... The other people who live in this place, not to hear me. Because, like, the old couple that lives below me, they already complained about me using the washing machine on a Sunday. And, like, this is Germany after all. We don't use the washing machine on a Sunday. Because not only does it produce noise that can be annoying, it also, like, is a testament to improper planning of your week. When you have to use the washing machine on a Sunday, you fucked up. And people don't like to live with other people who fuck up. So yeah, no more washing on Sundays. Or after 6 p.m. Hey, why is this already perfect? Oh, because I sometimes like bringing in these for rough tumble. You can name either rough or tumble, like that's double value, so you're double as likely to hit. But I think I'm just gonna keep it like tribal force mage. Like, I like it against all Delver decks. The deck where I like it the least against is actually this one, because it's super tempo oriented and this guy needs a little bit more mana to actually be effective. On the other hand, it's actually almost like a counterspell to Rough Tumble. And this definitely gives us the edge. We are here to figure out how good the card is, so that's what we will do. Oof. Usually when you have full houses and elves, it's not good. This is better. It's still a bit awkward, but it's better. I kind of want to draw a land now. The most awkward part about this hand is that you want this to get black. But, okay, this makes it so much easier. Does he have removal? Because he could play this first to protect this. But I think what I actually want to do here is do this to set up a potentially really good glimpse next turn. And if he does something about this, that's okay. I'd rather lose my Senate than to lose my Deathwatch Shaman. So this, once again, is one of those middle-of-the-road plays where I think the average center of mass on the value scale is more towards us, no matter the outcome. Unless he has spell pierce, of course. Fetches. Ponder. Do it. Oh, he doesn't have Stifle. He would have Stifled the fetch land. Maybe he's scared. Maybe he wants to play Delver that he just drew this turn. I don't know. And he's scared of doing it. No, that doesn't make sense. Bolt. Okay. Land. Come on, land. Deathrite is fine. Because Deathrite once again puts pressure on him. Deal with Deathrite. Or die to the glimpse. Still no green. Even though green's the thing that's the least threatening thing in his deck, red is definitely the most threatening thing because of Fog Bolt and Rough Tumble. It's also weird he would play the Wasteland first. Like, the Wasteland is the only... I mean, if he's already 100% sure he's gonna cast his member, it doesn't make a difference. But can you really, like, you also have to account for making mistakes, like, for not being perfect. Okay, oh, this is really sweet now. Sweet, sweet. Imagine he had to draw on a spell pierce or either had a spell pierce or another land in hand. I guess he wouldn't have had another land in hand if he placed Wasteland here. But if he had spell pierce and then found a land of the Ponder, and then he would be like, kind of almost have... See, this is one of those spots where he's probably thinking about whether he should force a fill this, because if he does not and we eventually pass the turn, then he's like, oh, I have this Rough Tumble. Then it's good for him. How am I going to do it? I think I'm going to do it like this. And if I had a Cavern Therapy here, I would eventually, for sure, like, try to set up the turn in a way that I would... Cavern Therapy for Rough Tumble here. I mean, it's pretty obvious. Not that he potentially has it, but that you want to do that. But just saying. Would be especially weird if he wastelanded here. Like, some people, they just want to wasteland as soon as they possibly can. It would be really weird because then it would eat... add even more food to the Deathrite, which would have maybe become relevant later on had he not Force of Will here. And the Force of Will is annoying because now it's even more likely that he has Rough Tumble. Because he's like, no, I can't let you have this card. Let's see. I still like drawing a card because eventually it will get us closer to Choke. And when the opponent doesn't have any kind of pressure, Choke is so devastating for them. Also, we need to find more land because we're gonna lose the Cradle. And potentially also the rest of our board. At which point losing the Cradle. it's still annoying, because otherwise we can use it, like, once we rebuild.
Triple kill.
There's the Rough Tumble. That's okay. What do I like here? I think I like just getting Deathrite Shaman. And maybe I should fetch while I can. I'm gonna get the other basic. No need to run into Stifler. Could see him playing what's it called? Tamogolf here. Oh, Forkbolt, okay. That's okay. Nimble Mongoose, that's annoying. We need to find Firewood Symbiote soonish. Okay. You can also put on our own offense. I'm scared of, like, I kind of want to get Triad Arbor here because it gives us so much more mana. On the other hand, we might not get to having black mana if that happens. And we there's a good chance that, oh, that's a great card, that we might need black mana. Black mana. I feel like I'm in some kind of crazy metal band where you need the black mana for the black mana god. I don't love doing this because then we lose our guy to Lightning Bolt. But overall, I think it's worth the risk. Oh, dismember? Yeah, it feels like dismember. I think I'd rather. Oh no, it doesn't make sense to remove cards from his graveyard because he's still gonna stay at 7. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, that's the thing I didn't consider. Yeah, I should have considered that. Not dismember, but in general, that if we wait for a turn, then we get to play this and then take out his entire graveyard. Because I was like, yeah, it's better to play it like to be a little bit safer. But the Nimble Mongoose is beating us down, and maybe I want to get my offense on. But I totally forgot that we get to like render his offense completely useless if we do it next turn. Play the use next turn. Yeah, that was a mistake. I didn't consider that we can take out, like, and we can shrink this guy. But it's still not. Oh, wow. I was just about to say, it's not like we will actually definitely lose this damage race. Oh, I should have played it. Oh, that was another mistake. Because now we might run into choke. If this runs into choke, it's so bad. Into daze. Makes you wonder how I ever win a tournament. this was really bad. Maybe he's gonna play another Tarmogoyf. At least this. I was playing like a brain dead stupid man. Also, I should have played this the other way around. If he has only got one card, then it doesn't matter. If he has two cards, it matters because he might not force a full Deathrite Shaman, thinking that we have got another card in hand that he really wants to force a full. So who's winning the damage race now? I think he still is. We deal 4. He takes us down to 6. We take him down to 4. He takes us down to 3. He take him down to 0. But he's got more relevant cards that he could draw. On the other hand, Clarion Ranger is already like almost lethal. 2, 4, 6. Yeah, 6. That choke play really haunts me. That was not very good. What did he do? He didn't shuffle, which probably means he's got a removal spell. Does not, okay. Maybe his plan is to double. No, double bolt doesn't do it. He could have stopped all of. Oh, this is really annoying now. If you take him down to 4, then he takes us down to 1. Oh, this is. This is not fun. We should have won this game. Well, we shouldn't. Like, I'm not talking about this cosmic karmic thing where one player is supposed to win because of whatever reasons. No, I'm talking about... I should have played better. So... I think I'm not gonna win this game if I sit back, so I really have to put on some pressure. Do I even have a Dryad Arbor left? Yeah, I do. I do. I'm kinda playing to stifle here, but at this point that's okay. I just wanna see what he is doing in his turn. Is there Pendlehaven left in the deck? Yeah, because if he shoots the Deathrite Shaman, then we can potentially like kill him if we draw Pendlehaven. It's not very likely though. Yeah, I think I have to... What happens if I gain life? Then I go to 5, go to basically 5, then to 4. But do I want to bet everything on drawing Pendlehaven? Probably not. Oh, this was so stupid. Oh, okay, let's get over this. Is gaining life worth it? What else can I draw? The problem with draining him is we go down to 3 on his attack, and then we go down to 2 on the fetch, and then we're dead to the Grim Lavamancer anyway, so I think it's... I should do it like this. We only got a single Abrupt Decay left in the deck. I guess we could also find another... Oh, that choke play. That fucking choke play, it's not leaving me. I'm not known for hanging on to these things, but... Yeah. I guess you gotta look like a donk every once in a while. So people can be like, oh, I would have won this. Which I certainly do when I watch other people play and I'm like, oh, I spotted a mistake. And then I'm like, oh, cool. I saw something the other guy didn't. So do I go down to 4? I think going to 4 is fine. Because we get to attack for 3 and then for 2 and then Pendlehaven's another out. Like the turn after. Or even this turn. Like if he's got nothing else. Or we can draw Senate, but Ooze is already gone, right? Ooze is gone. Pretty sure Ooze is gone. Scavenging Ooze is gone. Oh, we can draw Tribal Force. Tribal Force Mage doesn't do anything here. What if we attack for 3 and then we get... Well, Symbiote is the obvious one. What if we get Deathrite Shaman? Then he kills Deathrite Shaman. Takes us down to 1. I think it's better to just draw cards. Because we really do need cards. Force? I wouldn't hate Force here, yeah. Force pitch, oh, pitch Delver even. I can't attack with everything because then I'm dead. Dead, dead, dead. Yeah, that's how it goes against Canadian. Make one mistake too many. Actually, usually one slip up is already enough to lose. Ah, okay, let's see. Yes, I have to block. And then I have to win on my turn, because otherwise two Lava Metal activations kill me. So what am I trying to draw here? Symbiote into Decay. Symbiote into Decay wouldn't be the worst. Symbiote into Decay would probably be the best. Because just Decay doesn't do it, because then we still have to like double jump. Or at least single jump, and that's still hard. Or even double jump if he takes out one of our guys. Basically double lose the creature. Send us a message. Gonna roll the dice and hope you don't draw Natural Order. Well, I don't have Natural Order in the deck right now. And I'm gonna pass. Playing this guy out gives him perfect information. even though there's nothing I could have drawn anyway. At least we kinda know now that he certainly respects natural order, which he probably still should post-board. Or abrupt decay. Well, abrupt decay, abrupt decay wouldn't really do too much. I guess I could, if I had natural order and had abrupt decay, I could abrupt decay this and then block these two and then have still not enough. Yeah, I would have a single creature. Okay, third game. Lava Mensa, huh? Like, a lot of times I'm on the verge of bringing this in against Canadian, just because of Wasteland and of how important having Cradle in the matchup is. And now him having Lava Mensa makes me think I really want this, but maybe I want this instead of Force Mage. Seriously. I wouldn't hate doing that, but I want to try out how good Force Mage is. But it can also be Stifle. I probably took out Stifle, I don't know. It's also a creature. Okay, let's do it like this. I still have three abrupt decays. And Lava Mensa is pretty slow. Come on, take my submission. I would like to play first, yes. Oof. Oh god. This head really needs to draw something, but we are gonna draw a single card a turn, so there's something. But this hand is really not... This is like the worst possible hand that I would still keep. Healing Mulligan's down to 6. And, well, it doesn't really matter to me what he does. Whether he kept on top or bottom doesn't really influence my decision making at all. I mean, it's nice to know, and you probably should keep these bottom, okay. Keep these things in mind, but yeah. I'm gonna play. Am I gonna play something? The reason I'm playing the Wirewood Symbiote here is that I want to have Gaia's Cradle active next turn, and I'm not gonna cycle one of the glimpses because then he gets value of a Stifle on the Verdant Catacombs. Is this gonna be end of turn Brainstorm? No, there's nothing you wanna play on the next turn. It's not like there's any card you really, really wanna play on the next turn. Delva, okay. Okay, I guess this will have to eat the Stifle now. Closing my eyes. Stifle, okay. Since this was gonna get dried up anyways, that's okay. Are we gonna trade these? I think we're in for the long game, and I think he's actually not gonna block here. Or he might actually block if he has another creature. Oh, he's not, okay. Flip off Dismember. Little does he know that the most annoying part about Dismember right now is that it turns off the Gaia's Cradle. Oh, Goyf, okay. So no Dismember Reno. If he taps out this aggressively, I sense Force. In which case, what should I do? Thing is, if I choke here, he forces. If I get Visionary, he forces. And then, if he forces Visionary, and then we get choked down, choke is almost useless, because then Goyf is still good enough, and we've got nothing. Yeah. I think I'm gonna start with choke, and then have Senate, hopefully, next turn. Pitches Ponder, so he's got Dismember plus X. Just hope he doesn't dismember. He definitely dismembers here. Ugh. I'm a bit stupid. What I should have done is play Green Sun Senate for Dryad Arbor and then still have 3 mana and play the Choke and then get the Choke forced, but then have like 4 mana on my turn and then I can get a really good glimpse. Ah, yeah, this. See, these are the stupid, rusty, strategic mistake. Oh, that's actually a tactical mistake. Oh, this is such a stupid mistake. Ooze helps, but not as much as I wanted to. But at least you can do this now. Oh no, but if I do it like this, then Ooze can't even eat the Violet Symbiote, which I really wanted to. So Goyf shrinks, but we still take 7, but then we might be able to stabilize. So say I take 7 next turn, go down to 2, and if I do it this way, I go to 10, and I take 6, so I go to 4. And then I still eventually lose to Insect Liberation. I think I have to make the risky play now. I don't love it. Don't love it at all. F6. And hope to get that. This is the thing where you just like close your eyes and F6 and hope that it's good enough. Had I made the choke play the way I wanted to, I could have played the Ooze and then had 3 mana up, which would have been like a world of difference. Yeah, but that's how it goes. You really can't afford making too many mistakes with elves. Elves is not the most forgiving deck in the meta. I mean, there are even less forgiving decks, but elves certainly punishes mistakes, especially against Diver. Another Goyf. Okay, if that's the best he has. Or maybe if we draw like a creature, a prop decay for, oh wow. So suddenly, how I can't even remember the lyrics of Imagine. Suddenly, no, but I always keep remembering the thing about like, love was such an easy game to play. Anyway, oh no, that's not even Imagine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cast her. Animate Cradle. Get 3 mana. No, it doesn't do much. What if I do it like this? Like this. And like this. Do we have like a sorcery? No, but we got a land. Thinking about it. It would have been... Oh, I should have done it on his turn. Because then with the last mana, I would eat the Goyf. But maybe he's not going to attack with the Goyf anyway. Okay, so it's okay. Okay, so it's okay. No blocks, but F6. Yeah, but Abrupt Decay. Seriously, what's going on with me? No, I didn't have a lobotomy or something while I was away. I just feel like sometimes I'm playing really... Oh, he shoots me? No! Oh, but he could have shot me anyway. We should have forward-run this, had we played better. But yeah, so what's the verdict on Tribal Force Mage? Can't really say. Didn't really come up a lot of times. Right now I'm leaning towards trying it again to see how it works out. But thinking about it, I think I'd rather have a Lana Wife in the list right now. But yeah, guys, thanks for tuning in. There will be more content on this channel in the near future. I'm just super happy to be back to recording and probably also streaming in the near future, but let's not promise too much. And yeah, if you like this, leave a comment. If you don't like this, also leave a comment. And yeah, have a good time, have a good morning, evening, afternoon, wherever you are. See you next time.